Good day, students. In this clip, we're going to be going over an example on finding arithmetic sequences, finding the common difference, the nth term, and the explicit formula for the nth term of an arithmetic sequence. So let's take a look at the instructions for the examples. It says for the given sequence, determine if it is an arithmetic or geometric sequence. Find the common difference or ratio. Find the next three terms of the sequence. Find the value of A30. And then lastly, find the explicit formula and use it to verify your answer in D. All right, let's take a look at the sequence under consideration. For number one, we have 14. 4, negative 6, and negative 16, and then the sequence continues, okay? The difference between sequence and series is the elements of the terms in a sequence are separated by commas, whereas in a series, you have plus or minuses between them, okay? So think of sequence as just a list of numbers, whereas in a series represents a sum of numbers, okay? All right, so part A, we have to determine if it's arithmetic or geometric. So when you're thinking of arithmetic, let's just put a side note here. Arithmetic, we have a common difference. Common difference. For arithmetic, there's repeated addition or subtraction. That's how subsequent terms of the sequence are generated. On the other hand, for geometric, you have a common ratio, okay? Common ratio. So you constantly multiply to generate the next terms of the geometric sequence. So think of this as add and subtract, and then this one, think of it as multiply and divide, all right? So determine if it's arithmetic or geometric. We're going to see if our difference is a ratio, if we have a common difference or a common ratio. Okay, so we're going to start with arithmetic test first. For arithmetic series, the common difference D has to be equal to A2 minus A1, and it has to be equal to A3 minus A2, and it has to be equal to A4 minus A3, and that pattern has to continue. Basically, the formula for the common difference is A sub n, a term minus the term before it, is how you get the common difference, and you must get the same number every single time. All right, so let's look at this series. In this case, this is A1, the first term. The index tells you the position. Okay, we start from A1, AN is the last term. So that's A1, and then we have A2, and this is A3, and this term we have right here is A4. Okay, so let's use these terms to see if we are having a common difference here. Okay, if it's not a common difference, then this is not an arithmetic sequence. All right, let's apply the formula. A2 minus A1. A2 minus A1. A2 is 4, minus A1 is 14. Okay, and then what is this come? What does this come out to? 4 minus 14 is negative 10. All right, let's try A3 minus A2. A3 is negative 6 minus A2, negative 4. If you compute the difference, you have negative 10. Looking good. A4 minus A3. A4 is negative 16 minus negative 6. It becomes negative 16 plus 6. You can slash and dash these two. Negative 16 plus 6. The bigger number is negative, you subtract and keep the number of the sign of the bigger number. So this is negative 10 also. So what do you see about these three numbers? They're constantly the same. So this means that this is an arithmetic sequence. This is an arithmetic sequence. Sequence Y. Because we have a common difference, okay? Because There is a common difference. There is a common difference. All right. Another way to look at it is look at the pattern of numbers right here. From 10 to 4, subtract 10. From 4 to negative 6, you subtract 10. From negative 6 to negative 16, you subtract 10. So that's a pattern. They have a common difference happening over and over again. All right. Now let's take a look at the B part. It says find a common difference or ratio. Since we've determined that this is an arithmetic sequence, the whole idea of ratio is not applicable here. If this were a geometric sequence, then we'd be looking for the ratio, okay? But since it's an arithmetic sequence, we're looking for the common difference D, and that's done with the formula A sub n minus A sub n minus 1. This formula simply means that you subtract the term from the term before it to get the common difference, all right? So we can pick any two terms. We can, but there has to be a term. Any two terms will suffice. Okay, so how about we use n equals 3? So how would this apply to this formula? To find a common difference, a3, we're going to be using a3 minus a2. Okay, n minus 1, 3 minus 1 is 2. a3 is negative 6 minus a2, which is 4, and our common difference is negative 10. All right, so that's that. Now, one thing you want to note is if the common difference is negative, it causes the sequence to reduce in size. Okay, so that's what's happening here. So the sign is actually very important. And we also knew that this was our answer, right? Because we had already determined earlier that we're constantly taking out 10 from every term of our sequence. All right, let's move on to part C. It says find the next three terms of the sequence. So let's rewrite the sequence. Part C, the first term, A1, is 14. The second term, A2, we're given was 4. A3 is negative 6. A4 is negative 16. We have to find the next three terms. So let's look for A5. How do you find A5? To find A5, we'll simply subtract the common difference from the term before it, right? So negative 16 minus 10. What we're doing technically is we're adding negative 10. Same thing as subtracting, right? So negative 16 minus 10 is equal to negative 26. And then A6. How do we find A6? You start from the term before it, negative 26, which is A5, and you subtract the common difference. Again, let's do that in green. Subtract the common difference again. That gives you the next term, minus 10, which equals negative 36. And A7, the seventh term, you take the term before it, negative 36. Subtract the common difference, so you add the common difference. Add the common difference, negative 36 minus 10 is negative 46. All right, so next three terms are negative 26, negative 36, and negative 46. These correspond to terms 5, 6, and 7. So the index basically tells you the position. All right, let's go to the next part, part D. So for part D, we are asked to find A30. Okay, to find A sub 30. Now, what on earth does this mean? This means that we're to find the value of the 30th term, okay? So what is the formula for finding the nth term of a arithmetic sequence? There's a formula for that, and the formula is an equals a1, the starting term, plus n minus 1, number of terms minus 1, times the common difference. So that is the formula we're going to be using. There's another way of doing it where you can just simply keep subtracting your common difference, adding your common difference repeatedly, and then you get the nth term. But this is faster because it gives you, you can jump from the first term to your nth term by taking advantage of the multiplicative nature of the common difference, all right? So let's go ahead and use this formula. A30, in this case, you can clearly see that n is an index, okay? It's always the index. So n equals 30. A1 is the first term of the sequence, which is 14. D is a common difference. We already determined that. That is negative 10. So we're going to plug all these values into our formula right here. So we're going to have A sub 30 is equal to A1, which is 14, plus N minus 1 D, 30 minus 1, times the common difference, which is negative 10. That equals, now this expression we just simplify using order of operations, all right? Please excuse my idea on tally. So let's deal with the parenthesis first. 30 minus 1 is 29, times negative 10. Next operation is multiplication. So we're gonna have 14 minus 290. And then 14 minus 290 is equal to negative 276. And that's your 30th term of your sequence, okay? Now let's move on to part E. For part E, we are to find the explicit formula and then verify the accuracy of answering D using that formula, okay? So find the explicit formula for the sequence. That's basically simplifying the nth term formula for any arbitrary term, n, okay? So the formula for nth term we know is an is equal to a1 plus n minus 1d. So all you simply do is plug in a1 and d, and that helps you find the formula for the nth term, okay? So in this case, n is equal to, guess what, n. All right, that's the only difference between this and part D. N is equal to n, a1 will assume the value of a1, which is 14. D is going to be negative 10, all right? So you see the difference between these two. This has a specific n value, which is 30, but when you're looking for the explicit formula, this is how you do it, okay? So remember, we're looking for the explicit formula for the nth term. All right, so let's go ahead and simplify this. We're gonna have an equals the first term, which is 14, plus n minus 1, n is still n, minus 1 times the common difference of negative 10. Simplify this, we'll have 14 plus, now we'll just simply distribute this 10 to these two terms right here. We distribute, we're going to have negative 10n minus 10 minus 1 is plus 10. Okay, now let's simplify further. 14 plus times minus is minus, minus 10n plus 10. All right, let's combine like terms. This and this are like terms, they're constants. So we can combine them into 24 minus 10n. So this formula is the explicit formula for the nth term, explicit formula. All right? Okay, so we have found the explicit formula. Is it right or is it wrong? Is it correct? Now what we're going to do is we're going to use this explicit formula to find the 30th term and see if we end up with the same answer of negative 276, okay? So what we're doing right now is a test, okay? If it's wrong, if we do not get this answer, that means either our explicit formula is wrong or our computation in part D is wrong, or both of them are wrong, okay? So hopefully we get the right answer, that then we'll be confident that we're in fact correct, okay? So let's do it. So for the explicit formula, all you need is the nth term, okay? So in this case, n, or the position, n we need, n is 30. So let's plug it into the explicit formula. So a sub 30 is going to be equal to 24 minus 10 times n, which is 30. And if you do it, simplify this using order of operations, 10 times 30 is 300. And then 300 minus 24 is negative 276. And that is perfect. That is exactly what we had here. So we're confident that our answers are correct, our explicit formula and our nth term result for part D are also accurate, all right? So that's that. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. Feel free to subscribe to our channel for updates to other cool math clips such as this. More clips can be found on mathgoodserve.com. Thanks again for watching, and have a wonderful day.